Hi, Reverend Grant. Us an Assembled Assassin, and this is the side quest, a treasury of legends.
You are the Eagle Bearer! Wonderful! Magistrate Xanthi has spoken highly of you.
Very kind of her.
So here's the thing. My children have promising futures, but they refuse to learn and study. They think they know better, but they can't recite a poem to save their lives.
Where do I fit into this?
They've heard of the Eagle Bearer and worship the ground you walk on. If you related an epic story to them, I'd bet they retain it and impress their tutors.
It's an odd request, but I've been asked to do stranger things. I'll do it.
My children are waiting inside the Temple of Dionysus Kolonatas for today's epic story. The subject is Perseus, which they should know well, but seem to forget all one question.
I know the story well, of course, but my preferred version may not be what your children expect.
Do not fear. If you need a reminder, there are many relics related to Perseus in the hall adjacent to the Temple of Dionysus Kolonatas.
Good to know.
Where?
What? Oh. Ah. Hi. How do I know the order?
Glakov, Evrisitechne, Polylisti Vasilia,
oh, no, that's probably a thingy majiggy mahiggy, a animada straka. I'll grab that. I have no idea. We'll wing it, it'll be fine.
Hello, I'm.
The Eagle Bearer! We've heard all about you!
Are you going to tell us a story today?
Sure, kid.
We have to listen.
Shh.
We've heard it 100 times.
Yes, that's me. And yes, I'm telling
Sing
you a story.
Version.
Gather round and listen, children, while I spin you the yarn of Perseus.
Shower? What? That sounds really disturbing. We're gonna... He's Zeus's kid though, isn't he? That sounds weird. I'm gonna go.
Great god of the sea, Poseidon, visited a mortal woman, Sarah, a fisherman's daughter. The god of the sea frolicked with her in the shape of a dolphin, and she knew his love.
Ugh. Is this a kissing story?
Relax, I'm just setting it up. Soon, Sarah gave birth to a child, the half-blood hero, Perseus.
I thought Perseus's mother's name was Danae, like my sister.
Yeah, and his father was Zeus.
Well...
Yeah, but it
did... That's true in some versions. Anyway, at some point, baby Perseus fell off a boat and almost drowned.
It was weird. Okay, but... No. That's Hercules, right?
Perseus and his mother Danae were rescued on the island of Seriphus. And Perseus grew up under the care of a kindly fisherman, Thictis.
Lucky them! Did the gods help?
Maybe. Perseus learned to swim and ride and fight, and how to be good and just, even though his father was only a fisherman.
I can do all those things too!
Good for you.
Except swim,
or be just.
Hush. Now, Victis' brother was the ruler of the island, but he was not a good man.
He's scum.
When Perseus grows up, he travels to Iope and falls in love at first sight with the beautiful Princess Andromeda. However, Andromeda's mother boasts that her daughter is more beautiful than the goddess Thetis. Offending her,
never say you are better than the gods.
Thetis proclaims that Andromeda must be sacrificed to the gods, or else the whole city of Yopi will be destroyed.
I don't think that's right. Oh. Wasn't Andromeda an Ethiopian princess?
Oh.
Hush! Perseus asks his grandmother, Talla, how to save his love. She turns into a manta ray and says to save Andromeda, he must bring back curly hair of gold, fit for the king of the mountains, who yet owns less than the humblest Elot.
I don't know that riddle.
It's too hard!
I've lost another kid.
It was hard for Perseus, too. But eventually, he figured it out.
How?
He just did his own. Polydectes told Perseus to bring back the head of Medusa, the Gorgon whose gaze could turn anyone who looked into her eyes to stone.
Ah!
Polydectes knew that Medusa would be Perseus' death.
That stinker!
But the evil king did not know Perseus was favored by the gods. Hermes gifted Perseus with winged sandals and a silver sickle, and Athena gave him a bronze shield. Polished, mirror bright. Perseus flew to Medusa's lair and used the shield to watch her reflection. He cut off her head with the sickle of Hermes. As she died, the winged foal Pegasus sprung from her neck.
Yes!
Flying home, Perseus found the maiden Andromeda chained on the Ethiopian cliffs, waiting to be sacrificed to the baleful sea monster Ketos. Perseus used Medusa's head to turn Ketos to stone, rescued Andromeda, and married her.
Take that, Ketos!
Perseus returned home to find King Polydectes relentlessly pursuing Danae. They quarreled, and Perseus showed the king his wedding gift. When he saw Medusa's head, Polydectes turned to stone.
Yes!
I recently watched it, but I don't remember anything about the golden shower. Recently watched Clash of the Titans, the old one, but... Golden shower? Did that happen? Yeah, mustn't have been paying enough attention. Perseus competes in games and actually killing. He doesn't fight Hades, does he?
Perseus traveled to Argos with his family, and one day competed in the great athletic games. He hurled the discus.
No idea about
this. His throw was so great that it shot into the stands and struck King Acrisius. So doing, Perseus killed his grandfather and fulfilled the prophecy.
Hurrah!
You can't escape your fate.
In the end, Perseus and Andromeda settled in Mykene as king and queen, and had 7 sons and 2 daughters, the Perseidae.
Wow, that was so wrong and so boring. You are a sticky storyteller.
Oh, crud.
And that story was poop.
Oh, come on.
I am sorry for your audience, evil bearer. Though from what I heard, it did sound like you deviated somewhat from the traditional tale.
Apologies.
All right, everyone, that was the side quest, a treasury of legend. Game great, but it went somewhat.